All right, young scholars. The date is November 22nd, 1963. President Kennedy is assassinated in Dallas, Texas. We're at that site. Behind me is the Texas School Book Depository. And over here is the grassy knoll. And it is believed that the official report is that Oswald fired 3 shots from the 6th floor window. Others believe that there was a conspiracy involving a second shooter from up here on the knoll. So we're going to spend a little bit of time exploring this area.
At 12:30 p.m., President Kennedy's motorcade enters Dealey Plaza, making a sharp right-hand turn from Main onto Houston Street towards the open window at the Book Depository, followed by a hard left onto Elm.
The president's car is now turning onto Elm Street, and it will be only a matter of minutes before he arrives at the trademark. I was on Stemmons Freeway earlier, and even the freeway was jam-packed with spectators waiting their chance to see the president as he made his way toward the trademark. It appears as though something has happened in the motorcade route. Something, I repeat, has happened in the motorcade route.
In Dallas, Texas, 3 shots were fired at President Kennedy's motorcade in downtown Dallas. The first reports say that President Kennedy has been seriously wounded by this shooting.
So after the shooting happens, reporter Merriman Smith, a UPI reporter, he is the first one to call in the shooting, and he is the one that uses the phrase, 3 shots were fired. That's what gets reported by first ABC News and then CBS News. And Tom Dellard of the Dallas Morning News looks up and he takes one of the first photographs of the depository that morning.
Responding to gunfire, Officer Marion Baker's attention was immediately drawn to the Texas Book Depository. He was startled by pigeons flying off the roof. He left the motorcade to investigate, pushing his way through a crowd of spectators. It, however, would be 12 more minutes before the Book Depository was sealed off for investigation. While conducting their investigation of the School Book Depository, Dallas police searched the 6th floor. They noticed that the southeast corner window was walled off by a carton of books. Boxes were stacked in front of an open window, and 3 spent shells were found on the floor. Looking out the window, police observed that this offered a clear view of the motorcade route on Elm Street. Continuing their search, Dallas police found a rifle, a 6.5 Mannecker Kano, in the northwest corner of the Texas Book Depository, by the stairwell on the 6th floor. This rifle was later believed to belong to one of the Book Depository's missing employees, Lee Harvey Oswald. Ballistics were later matched from the bullets recovered from the president, Governor Connally, and the limousine to Oswald's rifle. In 1964, the Warren Commission presented their findings to President Johnson. They concluded that Lee Harvey Oswald acted alone and killed President Kennedy. From the sniper's nest on the 6th floor, Oswald watches as the president's motorcade moves up Houston Street. He loads the rifle. Then, as the car rounds the corner onto Elm Street, Oswald takes aim and fires his first shot. It's widely believed that the first shot is deflected by the traffic signal.
So behind me is the infamous Triple Underpass. This is where the third wounded man, James Tagg, was standing when a shot first hit the curb on the side of Elm and nicked his cheek.
Oswald reloads, takes aim, fires his second shot, which passes through the president's neck and hits Governor Connally. Oswald takes aim again, and at a distance of 265 feet at an angle of 7.5 degrees, he fires his third shot, hitting the president in the head. Oswald leaves the sniper's nest, walks across the 6th floor, stashes the rifle between boxes, and heads down 5 flights of stairs. Oswald is seen on the 2nd floor snack room where he's having a Coke. He then casually leaves the depository. He boards a bus which is stalled in traffic. He gets off that bus and enters a taxi cab to take him back to his boarding house in the Oak Cliff section of Dallas.
And the cab drops him off at this intersection, where he walks to his boarding house. The Warren Commission says that Oswald walked this distance, walked to his rooming house, walked back, and then had time to kill Officer Tippett, then get to the Texas Theater, all within, 45 minutes. So I'm moving. So I'm going to move at a casual pace. We'll see if it can be done. Gets to his boarding house at Beckley Avenue. He grabs his .38 and he puts on a light color coat. Now, it took me about 5 minutes, about 6 minutes to get there. He leaves 3 minutes later, the housekeeper says, and heads off in the direction we just came, heading back towards the direction of the Texas Theater. It's taken me 17 minutes to go a little more than a mile. So Oswald crosses over 10th Street, heading down Patton Avenue, and he's stopped by Officer Tippett. He pulls up almost where this truck would be. He pulls up, has a conversation. Oswald walks around to the front of the car. Officer Tippett is shot. This sets off a series of motions that will lead to Oswald's arrest. And he's heading to the Texas Theater, which is about a half mile away. Oswald is next seen lurking along Jefferson Avenue, which is where we're at here. Here at one of these points. So all the Dallas police are coming up Jefferson Avenue. They're going to the Tippett scene. And he dips in, this place. He dips in, draws the attention of Johnny Brewer. And his final destination is right up here, Texas Theater. So it took me about 28 minutes, just under a half hour, to walk that distance. So Oswald comes down Jefferson Avenue. Although he's got a bunch of cash in his pocket, he doesn't pay the cash attendant. Slips into the movie theater. Johnny Brewer calls for the Dallas police. They circle the theater. And shortly before 2 o'clock, Oswald's arrested right here.
When Oswald was arrested in the Texas Theater, instead of trying to escape, Oswald shouting, "I am not resisting arrest."
You find that rifle.
The people have been given, but I emphatically deny these charges.
For 48 hours, Lee Harvey Oswald was interrogated by Dallas police. He repeatedly denied having killed the president and Officer Tippett.
I've not been charged with that. In fact, nobody has said that to me yet.
All right, friends. So behind me is the Dallas Law Center, which is the old Dallas jail. It's where they took Lee Harvey Oswald on the night of November 22nd. And where that truck is down there is where he was going to be transferred to the county jail downtown.
On the morning of November 24th, during a routine prison transfer in the basement of police headquarters, nightclub owner Jack Ruby walks down the Main Street ramp, steps forward, and shoots Lee Harvey Oswald. Jack Ruby is immediately taken into custody. The murder is broadcast live on NBC. Lee Harvey Oswald is taken to Parkland Memorial Hospital, where he dies of his wounds. Thanks for exploring the Kennedy assassination with me today. We might never know for sure what actually happened that fateful day in Dallas. What do you think? Was President Kennedy killed as a result of conspiracy? Was there a gunman firing from the grassy knoll? Or was President Kennedy assassinated as the result of a lone gunman firing from the book depository? The evidence is there. You can decide.